And welcome back to the Halftime Report. I'm Dominic Chu at the New York Stock Exchange with the ETF Edge. Financials are on fire today, the best performing sector this month with the XLF ETF that tracks the broader sector in the S&P, the KBE Bank ETF, and the KRE Regional Bank ETF, all up around 9% as this group really starts to heat up. The sector itself is up nearly 18% this year. So what is the best way to play these moves? Tim Seymour of Seymour Asset Management, also Christian Magoon of Amplify ETFs, join me right now here. So perhaps, Christian, we'll start with you on the overall picture for this. As we tackle ETFs, are there ways that ETF investors are tackling the sector overall? I only ask it because it has been a slight underperformer over the course of this year-to-date period.
Yeah, it has, Dom. This is kind of a recent development where banks are rallying. You know, there's several ways ETFs investors can look at this differently than just buying XLF. One of them is to change the capitalization weighting of their ETF. So instead of doing market cap weighting, they could do equal weighting. Equal weighting emphasizes small and mid-cap companies more. They have more volatility on the downside, but also they have more volatility on the upside. So an ETF to potentially look at is RYF. That's the Invesco S&P 500 Financials ETF. It's equal weighted, and that's a way to maybe amp up the risk profile here if we're in a positive moving financial sector.
All right, so Tim, the financials are a huge mover today.
They are.
They're the outperformer without a doubt. So what exactly is driving that sentiment for ETFs today in the financial services sector? I ask only because now the KRE, that regional bank ETF, has now ticked above its 200-day moving average, that longer-term trend line, for the first time in quite some time.
So look bottom up, the regional banks look pretty interesting, right? Because there's a consolidation bid. We saw that with the SunTrust merger. I think people are looking for more consolidation. So owning a KBR is interesting. Christian talked about the KBE, which is essentially equally weighted. I would go back to XLF, and here's why. You have the money center banks, which make up 35% of this ETF, and then you have Berkshire Hathaway, which, frankly, I think you could strip out of there. Unfortunately, it's 12% of the index. But bottom line here, since earnings, we've seen that year over year, banks are actually still near record profitability, but the decline in rates has largely been priced in. In fact, it's outperformed the S&P, the XLF, about 5.5% since rates bottomed. I think headwinds on interest rate or net interest margins are offset by actually easing credit conditions. And I think the money center banks, relative to everything else we're talking about in the sector, you can get in an ETF, look the cheapest relative to their long-term average. 9.5 times, that's cheap to its history.
All right, Christian Magoon, Tim Seymour, thank you guys so much for joining us today.